Hey, this is Tim Strange, and you're listening to SWN.
Hello, and welcome to the SWN podcast. I'm your host, as always, Billy. This is the year-end awards. I'm hoping it all goes well, because I'm still streaming through Zoom, through to Facebook Live, and seeing how it works out. So I'm just going to try and bring up the whole comments, see how that works, because technologically I am not great with this. See if I can actually look at things. Right, okay, so I've got the comments in front of me. Hopefully you guys can jump in and see me. I don't know how this is going to totally work, but we'll see how it goes. I'm just going to try and take off some little bits and pieces here, so it looks all fancy and nice for the actual video itself. Anyway, right, okay. Don't know how to do that. Let's just go for it. So yes, welcome to our year-end awards. It's been ages since I asked you to do the initial vote. That was back on the 1st of January 2023. We're now on the 26th of January, and the voting closed on the 14th of January as well. So it's been a while. But I've got the results. I've tallied them. I've made all the fancy graphics that you'll see on the website tonight at about 9 o'clock. If you're listening to this after the event, I'll probably have it up on the YouTube channel and on our audio feed. It'll be probably on Friday late morning. But in the meantime, I'm here live on Facebook awaiting your comments when we're doing the results. So I've got all the stats in front of me, everything I could possibly have. I can't remember if I said my name. It's Billy, of course. I am the guy at SWN, Scottish Wrestling Network. And this is very exciting. I'm really excited to do the results for this awards, because this has been quite a good one. It's been a really great year that we've had in 2022. And now we're in 2023. It's looking like it's going to be a fantastic year going forward as well. Some housekeeping. You're on Facebook Live right now if you're watching it live right now this very second. If you're not, you can go follow us on Facebook, which is facebook.com/ScottResnet. Same on Instagram, instagram.com/ScottResnet, and Twitter @ScottResnet. I think we're that on YouTube now as well, which I think it's slash Scottish Wrestling Network, or you can find us at ScottResnet as well. Which is all good. My voice doesn't sound the best. I will be absolutely perfectly. I know it doesn't sound great. I got test positive for COVID this time last week. I'm still kind of recovering from that. I'm clear, negative, all good in the hood. I'm still just a bit choked up and sounding a bit rough. I'm also doing this late at night, and my son's asleep, so that really does temper my voice as well, so he doesn't wake up and we have an interruption on the stream here. So yes, the awards. So last year, I was looking to see how many votes we got last year, and across all the categories, we got about 350 votes, something like that. This year, across all the categories, we got over 2,000. So it's been a pretty good year for votes. We did quite well in the 14 days. I've got lots of entrance, a lot of completed forms, some of which had some weird answers. I won't lie to you, there were some odd choices, but you know, it was your choice and your choice alone to make. There's also some cases of people just didn't read the questions and were putting in random answers and or not completing the question fully, but I've taken that into account. I haven't like totally scratched off your votes. If I can decipher them, I will count them. That's pretty much how it's worked out there. So if you didn't see the preview show, I did a big preview of past winners. We discussed possible contenders of who's going to win for the votes this year. So we'll go through a little bit of that as we go along as well. So for anyone watching, if you're a wrestler, I'm still actually just a little plead as well. I'm still after show introductions. So if you're able to go, my name is yada yada, welcome to SWN. Maybe put your name instead of yada yada. That would be excellent. That would be ace. Give me a shout. DM me. Email me, scottresnet@gmail.com. That would be wonderful. Let's do this. Let's get into some awards. Right. So we'll just start with the top and work my way down, because it's easier for me to keep track of them. So we'll start Wrestler of the Year, then we'll finish with Podcast of the Year. That seems like a good way to do it. So I will tell you who's 3, 2, 1. and all that kind of jazz. But before I do that, we'll go through our admin awards. We've got an Outstanding Recognition Award, which of course is our Hall of Fame Award, which is who goes into our Hall of Fame each year, which has seen the past guys like Drew Galloway, Wolfgang, Carmel Jacob. And this year it is Grado. Grado is going into our Hall of Fame class this year. Funnily enough, I don't think I've plugged it enough recently. We have Grado on the SWM podcast. This episode that goes out tomorrow. Recorded it last week, just before COVID. Recorded it last Tuesday, and it's going out tomorrow on Friday, the 27th of January. That's a big bucket list guest that I had that I wanted to have on the show, and I finally got it. We finally got it arranged. It was a quick 45-minute chat. Wish I had more time. Circumstances made it so I didn't have as much time as I'd hoped. And Grado had more time than I had. We figured it out. We got a little bit of time in there. I've got a great 45-minute chat with Grado coming up tomorrow. I can't wait for you to see it and hear it. It's like I say, bucket list stuff. Speaking of bucket list, I got to speak to Mike Bondo as well, the podcast, recently. For me, that's bucket list because I've got an action figure of Mikey from Spirit Squad. And it was cool to speak about his time at Discovery Wrestling and all that stuff as well. So go check out those episodes for season 5. So yes, Grado, Outstanding Recognition Award for Extraordinary Service. I wish I picked the name of an award that I could say out loud properly. The other things that we did this year for the awards is, of course, the SWN 100, which was a compiling, it was like our PWI. We compiled wins, title wins, title defenses, promotions worked, and et cetera, et cetera. Number one in the SWN 100 this year was Taylor Bryden, which was a great, really great concept. I'm really looking forward to doing it again next year. Hopefully we can kind of refine it a little bit. But really, I kind of got my subs okay. I'm quite happy with the results of the top 100. Of course, there was folks that were just so close or just in a position because of maybe just the cutoff point being like the first 30th of November. And then they did great things like the 1st, the 2nd, 3rd, and 4th of December, which would have bumped them up. But that will be taken into account next year when we do the SWN 100 again. That's the plan, that's the hope, and that's the prayer. Let's see. Right, and we've also had our monthly poll awards, which was kind of the tallying of the monthly poll award that we do each year. Make sure this can actually go live because something seems to be going a bit odd right here. Oh, right. There we go. Right. Hi, Lewis. Thank you for joining us. Oh, God, now you've commented. I know that people can actually see the stuff on here. So that's good. It's excellent. Wonderful. Did that comment come in 5 minutes ago? I just saw it now. That's not a good sign. Okay. I'll try and catch as many comments as I can as I go along. So we had our monthly awards. Each month we do our SWN monthly poll. You vote for wrestler month, match of the month, the promotion of the month, and not promotion of the month. It's match of the month, wrestler of the month, show of the month. That's it. I've done it for like 6 years. I really should know. And from that, we gathered the results at the end of the year. We take it from December to January to December because we finish that kind of run up. About the 7th of December or 7th of January. So I can tell you the results of those as well. So SWN monthly poll will go for promotion of the year. In third place was Fair City Wrestling. Fair City Wrestling becoming in third place there when we were taking into account match and show of the month. Second place was Discovery Wrestling. And in first place was WrestleZone. I think I may have done too well of a job. Just telling everyone how good WrestleZone is this year. I'll be honest with you, we may see in the future results as well. Wrestler of the Year, my SWM monthly poll. And third place, it was a three-way tie. It was Caleb Valhalla, Emerson Jane, and Jack Morris. In second place was Zach Dynamite. And in first place was Aspen Faith for Wrestler of the Year. So he won quite a few Wrestlers of the Month. And he also was a part of quite a few matches of the month as well for WrestleZone and for Discovery Wrestling as well. So really great. Yeah, I'm happy with that. And like I say, this is all voted for by you. Of course, I have a clear bias elsewhere that one of my favorite wrestlers. But if you guys have voted for it, then you guys have voted for it. That's pretty much it. So yes, so there we go. Ask with Faith, SWN Monthly Poll, Wrestler of the Year, and WrestleZone was SWN Monthly Poll, Promotion of the Year. Let's finally get to the big guns. Let's get to the actual awards itself. So if all these are fan voted, I have checked all the votes. I have tallied them. Like I said, I've even taken ones that are spelt incorrectly. I've included them. I've done my best to make it as fair as possible for all the results. Like I said, we've got over 2,000 votes across all the categories. So we've got huge voting. This is really a big year for it, and I thank you very much for taking the time to complete the individual questions. And if you've got any questions about maybe who was in there, I'll try and throw out some names who were contenders, who were quite close to the top, but didn't quite make the top three. Right, so we'll go Wrestler of the Year, male. So male Wrestler of the Year last year was Andy Wilde, who picked up this particular award. In third place Wrestler of the Year is Jack Morris. Of course, Jack Morris is doing great things up in Noah in Japan at the moment. So third place, Jack Morris, he had quite a good number of votes in there. In second place, Wrestler of the Year is Joe Hendry. Of course, Joe Hendry at Impact Wrestling right now, Impact Wrestling's Digital Media Champion. He's doing amazing things. And in first place was the Lost Boy, Aspen Faith, brand new WrestleZone Undisputed Champion. He is number one in our votes, coming in really close in the categories. In this particular category, we had Zach Dynamite registering quite a lot of votes, Leighton Buzzard as well. Akilah Valhalla got quite a few also. So it was really great category, really wide spread as well. But Aspen Faith just nicked it towards the end there. But Joe Hendry and Jack Morris in second and third place, respectively, they're up there in the top three. But yep. Wrestler of the Year is Aspen Faith. We're moving on to Wrestler of the Year female. So as said in our preview show, next year I'm just going to merge these two categories together, and it'll just be Wrestler of the Year full stop, which should make things quite interesting when it comes to the divide and the split of having just all merged together as just a Wrestler of the Year and not splitting the categories further. Because it's a modern way. It's not fair. You got guys who don't fit into these categories, particularly flush. So it kind of makes it weird for people voting if they want to vote for someone in particular. Some people might think they go in one category, one might think they go in the other, and which makes it difficult to get a proper good tally of the votes. Anyway, Wrestler of the Year female. In third place, we have ICW Women's World Champion Molly Spartan. In second place, we have Discovery Wrestling Women's Champion, Casey. And in first place, it is the main event empress herself. It's Emerson Jane being Wrestler of the Year. So other folk that got really good votes in this, we had Angel Hayes, was really close to nipping into the third place. We had Brody Adler get quite a few votes as well as Fair City Wrestling, former Fair City Wrestling Women's Champion, Debbie Dahmer. I'm getting good few votes in there for Wrestler of the Year in the female category. So in our close one, in our really close call, but it was Emerson Jane who was picking up the win this year. Last year's winner, of course, was Angel Hayes. And Emerson Jane picks up her second Wrestler of the Year award. She won back in 2017 also. So well done, Emerson. Moving on to Tag Team of the Year. For my voice being absolutely woeful, I don't know if we're gonna like do an hour or if we'll just see what happens. So Tag Team of the Year, so previous winners have included the 99. We've had Glasgow Grindhouse, Kings of Catch, Polo Promotions. In third place it is KOE, who are ICW Tag Team Champions at the moment. So KOE, Adam and Marcus King in third place. In second place, we've got the current WrestleZone Tag Team Champions, the Fair City Saints, Alex Webb and Air Miles. And number one, the Foundation of the Future. So Tag Team of the Year this year on the SWN Year-End Awards, it's Ryan Riley, Bruiser Brad Evans, Zach Dynamite, the Foundation of the Future. So congratulations to them. And our really hotly tipped category, I have all, you know, who else was up there? Foundation of the Future, Fair City Saints, KOE. Redgate got quite a few votes as well. She-Wolf's got quite a few votes. So did Glasgow Grindhouse, Lucha Scotland, so, and Termination Z, Struthers Sisters. There's quite a few that were up there as possible winners as well. Brian Tucker, Reece Dawkins as well, the young team. There's plenty of votes in there for just about everyone, but those are the ones that just nipped it at the top. Right, okay, so I think we're on to International Talent of the Year. Previous winner, it was Big Demo. Big Demo won it last year. Of course, and one of the only person to win both Wrestler of the Year and International Talent of the Year. But this year, it was a bit of a weird one this year because this is our first full year back, really, 2022. There wasn't that many you would call international talents coming through. Quite a few from like the Scandinavia, but as well as like your proper big imports, I think there were quite a few far between when it came to it. But we were able to get votes. We got votes in for plenty of options. Some folk did go across the border, go to down to England to pick an option because Lana Austin got a few votes as well. So there was plenty of options for a winner. In third place, it is the current Copenhagen Championship Wrestling heavyweight champion. It's Nitro Green. In second place, he appeared in SWA this year. It was Dirty Dango. And in first place, he appeared a lot of times in Iron Girders Pro Wrestling. He had quite a few matches in there. I think he had a match of the month as well. It was the former Scotty Too Hottie himself. It was Scott Garland, winning International Talent of the Year in the SWN Year End Awards. So congratulations to Scotty Too Hottie, Scott Garland, for that win. So International Talent, we're getting through these. We're rattling through these results. We've got Move of the Year next. And whenever you get your comments in, hopefully I'll be able to answer some questions. I'm hoping to be able to see your answers, see your questions, but this whole use of Facebook, it works well for the microphone. I can use my headphones, but it's not my favorite thing in the world, but I like to at least do it and do it live so you can get some live reactions and some opinion and what have you. Right, okay, so we've got Move of the Year. So previously, Caleb Valhalla won with Hellride. This year, he's up there as a contender again. Get the whole things up in front of me. Move of the Year. This was the hardest one to kind of tally because it was just spellings and how people formatted it as well. I did ask to put the move and the name, the move and the wrestler, and most of the people did it. But like I say, I did try and tally as much as I could, and like as long as it wasn't totally obscure or wild spelling, I did kind of try and condense all the answers. So if you answered, one person did move name and another person did name move, I did obviously count them both as a vote. So we did our best, and I think we did all right otherwise. So in third place, it is Killshot by Zach Dynamite in third place there. In second place, it's last year's winner, Caleb Valhalla's Hellride. And in number one, Move of the Year for 2022, it's Aspen Faith's Darkest Lariat. So this is the old Chop Lariat combination, picking up a second award this year for the Darkest Lariat. And of course, Unwrestler of the Year is Aspen Faith. So we also had things like, we had Nicole Jasmine's Round Off Elbow, it was in there. ADM's Choke Breaker. We had Brainbusta, which I assume is Ian Skinner's. Kez Dispenser, Kez Evans. We got Curb Stomp from Ronan King. So we got quite a few options in there that you could put in there as a winner, but those were the top three for this year. Up next, it is Match of the Year. So we've got Match of the Year coming up. Again, this is our one where we went through all the options and kind of put them all together, because I think next year I may need to think of a way to make it more streamlined for myself to actually tally the responses. But we still did it. We got there. Right. Okay. So last year's winner was Stevie Boy versus BT Gunn at Fear and Loathing. And actually, every match of the year from 2015, when we started the awards, to 2021, has been a match at Fear and Loathing for ICW. So it's interesting to see how that goes this year. In third place, we've got Zach Dynamite versus Damien versus Aspen Faith at WrestleZone's Christmas Chaos Return of the Cage. In second place, It's Zack Dynamite versus Aspen Faith at WrestleZone Halloween Hijinks. And in first place, it's Aspen Faith versus Damien versus Zack Dynamite at WrestleZone Aberdeen Anarchy. So, Aberdeen Anarchy, all the trilogy of matches involving Damien, Zack Dynamite, and Aspen Faith, they all took the top three. Other contenders that came up in there, we had Emerson Jane, Taylor Bryden at FCW. We had Andy Weld, James Mason at FPWA. Paul Jasmine, Brody Adler at Fair City. Quite a few ones at Fair City, but they were quite spread out. Aspen Faith versus Mark Hastings at Discovery. KOE versus Glasgow Grindhouse. Kid Bandit versus Jesus Gooder Soft Pro. I don't know how that got in there because, you know, it's not a match. It took place in Scotland. But no, quite a few came in for likes of Andy Weld, James Mason. Thatcherite Grado also got a couple of votes as well from Community Pro Wrestling, as well as some matches at just FCW, Discovery, Pro 2 got one or two for Iceman versus Jack. So it was quite a spread list again, but the top three were all matches involving Aspen Faith, Zack Dynamite, and Damien popped in for one or two also. There we go. Right. Okay, so that's match of the year sorted. Feud of the year. This might not be any surprise when it comes to me. You just heard what match of the year was in the top three from that. So feud of the year, previously it was Kez Evans versus Craig Anthony, which actually picked up a little bit later on last year when it came down to it. They kind of collided again on the road to Fear and Loathing. Feud of the year. In third place, we've got Andy Wild versus Jason Reed for Insane Championship Wrestling. They had quite a good, quite a big kind of feud, a little bit of a team up, and then they broke up again. So that took the space of the year. In second place, we've got Redgate, which is Tommy Cross and Jacob Deacon Wild against Game On and Nathan North and Duke Cannon. In second place, they're at Fair City Wrestling. So they had a tag team rivalry that ended up have a table match in there as well. And also, that looks to probably continue into 2023 with Redgate becoming the FCW Tag Team Champions last week, as of recording. Number one, Feud of the Year, SWN Year End Awards. It is Zack Dynamite versus Damien versus Aspen Faith up in WrestleZone as your Feud of the Year. So another big win. Another win for Aspen Faith. I mean, I don't have awards per se, but if anyone wants a little like medal, I will source one and I will present them to you if you wish. Four awards for Aspen Faith. I don't know whether I should be chief in charge of hyping up Aspen Faith, but I seem to have done a good job in the last God knows how many years, 9, 10 years at this point. But he's picking up the votes. Like I said, these are all voted for by you guys. I am but the messenger in all of this as well. So where are we up to next? We're up to Show of the Year. Next up. So last few years, it's either been Discovery Wrestling or Insane Championship Wrestling has been, they kind of took turns about, and then Discovery's had the last couple of years. In third place, it is WrestleZone Halloween Hijinks. They're in third place there. In second place, WrestleZone Christmas Chaos, Return of the Cage. And in first place, it is WrestleZone Aberdeen Anarchy. So 1, 2, 3 for WrestleZone there for the year, for the Show of the Year. Other contenders, we had Discovery Wrestling tagged, got quite a few votes. Discovery Wrestling Year 7 gone there as well. Fair City Rumble as well. Renegade Cup Tournament from Renegade Wrestling Dojo. They got a couple votes as well. Monster Mash from Combat League Wrestling. Iron Girders got a couple. Someone just put ICW, which is no use to me. I don't know. It could be any show. Battle Lines from Pro 2 got a couple of votes in there as well. But that's your top three, with Aberdeen Anarchy being number one on the list. Promotion of the Year we've got coming up now on the awards. Let's see. So previously, again, it's been Discovery Wrestling and Insane Championship Wrestling that have taken turns back and forth each year, with Discovery taking it in 2021. In third place, it is Fair City Wrestling. Fair City Wrestling in third place. In second place, it's Discovery Wrestling. And I don't think it's going to be any surprise from the last three awards, promotion of the year, it is WrestleZone up in the Northeast. So obviously this promotion that we plug heavily because we go to the shows, so I'm able to write about them most. But they're the votes, they're the ones you voted for as your promotion of the year. Pro 2 got quite a few votes as well. Insane Championship Wrestling got a few votes. So did Renegade. Source Wrestling got a vote, got a few votes. Rivals got a vote. I don't know who did that. Reckless the Ted got a few votes as well. So it was, again, Community Pro Wrestling as well. So there's quite a few votes across the board. Again, we're so lucky in Scotland that we've got so many good, reputable companies. Well, we've got some non-reputable companies, but we've got good reputable companies that we can check out. And this year, WrestleZone has been chosen. They got about just over half of the votes, so they were well chosen, and that's who the fans have voted for. We're on to one to watch now. I am just blasting through this. I'm so sorry, everyone. I wish I could just do a load of other things and just like I banter back and forth. But yeah, I have underestimated COVID and how it is affecting my voice and throat. But we're getting there. We're going to get through the ones to watch, and we're going to do our podcast of the year, and hopefully, you'll still enjoy the remaining of the show. It's going to be good fun. Trust me. One to watch. So last year, 2021, was Ian Skinner, who, by his own self-admission, didn't have a great start to 2021, but I can honestly say he made up for it in the latter half with his work down south and just his overall just exuberance and wonderfulness as doing promos, the marketing himself so well. But 2021 was Ian Skinner's year. This year, in third place, it's Titanium Tom Atlas. Titanium Tom Atlas got in their third place from FCW. In second place, it is Judas Grey. Judas Grey, of course, one of Joe Henry's lads, and is making waves at like Discovery Wrestling and Reckless Intent. Number one to watch in the male category, and I almost regret saying this because he's never going to let anyone forget it, so I'm sorry. It is Ronan King. Ronan King was voted as your one to watch in 2023. Again, I said I apologize because he's just not going to let that go. We had Connor Malloy. He got a good number of votes this year. So Tommy Cartel, Spike Tierney, Sebastian Asher, Reece Dawkins got a good few. Colt Davis, Logan Smith. There was so many. It was such a great category to go through and go, oh man, I'm glad that people are enjoying these guys' work and they're able to just entertain people, and they've entertained whether it's one person that's voted for them or however many. Jarek Nowak, Novak, Rob Stowe got a few votes in there as well. So voted for Ancomuni. So yeah, it's been quite a good mix of talent this year in our one to watch in the male category. Coming up next, our female category. So we've got last year's winner was Brody Adler. Of course, is now the FCW Women's Champion. So if you win this, clearly gold is coming your way. That's the only conclusion I can take from that. In third place, it is Reckless Intent's JJ Lee, who had a few matches last year and shows all this potential in the world. Took a little bit of a break, but seems to be coming back in 2023. And is a great choice in there in third place. In second place, it is Daisy Jenkins. I'm a big fan of Daisy Jenkins. Every time I see a wrestler on YouTube, she's doing amazing work. I love her promo style, I love her style in general. In second place is Daisy Jenkins. And number one in our one to watch in the female category. Again, next year we're going to merge these into just one to watch category. It is Moxie Malone. Moxie Malone winning our one to watch for 2023. So there's the ones you're going to have to look out for. Those six names, they're the ones that people think that are going to be the next big thing in 2023. Other votes that came in, Brody Adler just missed out in the one to watch in that category. Emily Hayden as well, Mavis Struthers, Cassie King, Harmony Sky. Angel Hayes got a few. She's doing amazingly as well, but some people think there's still more that Angel Hayes could do. Ruby Roberts got a few votes. Ashley Vega as well, which is a great shout. as a one to watch. Jade Black as well. Nicole Jasmine. There was a lot of great votes in there with those three just tipping at the top for the wins, for the top three. One to watch in the tag team category. So in third place, it's Adam and Marcus King in KOE. So, of course, they were third place in our tag team of the year as well. In second place, it's the Struthers sisters, Maven and Raven Struthers and Iona Sky. And in first place, it is, I think they came second place in our tag team of the year. It is the Fair City Saints, Alex Webb and Air Miles. So not quite the team of the year, but they are the ones to watch for 2023, the current WrestleZone Tag Team Champions, which they'll be defending on Saturday coming up as well against the Outfit, who got a good few votes. There would be I didn't actually put a vote in. Silly of me. They got a good few votes, probably would have been the ones that I would maybe just try to push in as possible winners. The Young Team were nipping at the heels of the KOE. I think they just missed out by just a couple of votes, if that. Woke Academy got a good few votes as well. Strother Sisters, they were up there. Double D's as well. Good. I like the team of Debbie Dahmer and Dickie Divers. Great. Love it. Risky Business got a few in there. So did Casino Brutal. Legends Never Die. Game On as well. So there was a good mix. I love watching, reading the answers, because I could go, oh, they might not have got number one or might not have made the top three, but I could clearly see who to kind of look out for in 2023 or what people are kind of saying, and I could kind of check them out accordingly. Right, okay, so we're into promotion to watch. On to watch promotion. In third place, it's Fair City Wrestling. Fair City Wrestling in third place. They're also in third place for promotion of the year. In second place, it's Community Pro Wrestling. Community Pro Wrestling do great things. I've watched one of their shows recently. Their one-year anniversary show is on YouTube. I watched that back, and I had a good time. I had a good time watching it. And number one, your one-to-watch promotion for 2023, it is Iron Girders Pro Wrestling. Iron Girders Pro Wrestling, who are doing just incredible things at the moment. They're bringing in guys like Scotty Tuhoi to their shows, and they're showcasing a lot of Central Belt talent on their events. So Iron Girders Pro Wrestling is your one-to-watch promotion. So previous winners of those last two categories, because I didn't say who won, the tag team won. So last year, Thatcher's Cabinet won. Ian Skinner and Charles Weiss with Thatcher Wright. They won that particular category. The previous winners has been KOE, Foundation of the Future, Kings of Catch. For promotion, last year's winner was Fair City Wrestling. Previous winners has been Fierce Females. I haven't heard of them in a while. WrestleZone Scotland, Source, Reckless Intent. So it's quite a good company to be in. And our final award, you may be glad to hear me exasperating down the camera here. Because, that's, like I said, this COVID's no joke. This COVID's no joke at all. I've had, it's just been an awful time of it. But I'm cleared. Like I said, I'm clear and ready for going to go see some wrestling on Saturday. I'll just, if you think my face is a face of thunder previous times, then God, just you wait until you see the photos back of Station Hotel Showdown, because I'm just going to look tired, very tired. Other names, the other promotions that got picked up on the one to watch, Source Wrestling got a good few votes, WrestleZone also got a good few votes, so did FPWA, Pro 2 also got a good number of votes, so did Reckless Intent. So again, another Clyde Valley Wrestling as well, so another big mix, a good mix of shows and options that people were able to vote for. SWN Podcast of the Year. Now, this is the last award, and then I can talk about the podcast in general. I think I messed up this kind of particular category last year, but this year, because last year I did it as a poll, so you could just pick one, made life easier. This year made it a bit more difficult, because some of them I had multiple chats with throughout the year, which just made it difficult for me to kind of tally the votes, but I did my absolute damnedest to be able to do it, to tally the votes and be able to get an accurate reading. In third place, it was our episode with Daisy Jenkins. A great episode, really fun episode. And this was kind of just before, she did a couple matches in ICW and and had a few matches here and there, but now she's like getting all over the place. So Daisy Jenkins in third place. In second place, it was Scotty Swift's return to the podcast for episode 4, Afterlife. We still plan to get a fifth episode this year with Scotty. It's just me finding time. That's my premise. Because I know, because at the moment I've got maybe about an hour, hour and a half max for recordings. And I know that if I've got Scotty on, there's no chance we're going an hour, hour and a half. So I need more time. I'm going to find some time. I'm going to get Scotty in for the fifth episode. I've already got the title in mind. I know what I'm going to call it. So I can't wait to actually get to chat with Scotty again. And but in first place. So previous winners has included Ian Ambrose and Ian Skinner. And first place this year is Alex Webb and his second episode, Into the Webverse. This terribly titled episode, which should have been Into the Spiderweb, but here we are. So Alex Webb 2 Into the Web First is your podcast of the year. Funnily enough, his third episode, the Holiday Special, is the most viewed episode on YouTube right now. So like I said, a lot of people just put Alex Webb. Some put Alex Webb 2. Randy Valentine's episode got a couple votes. Some of them, it's like Jack Morris as well, which I don't think was the last year. I think it was last year. It was the year before. We've got Nicole Jasmine. The quiz got in there as well. A few votes. Thank you, because I love that particular episode. It was just absolute chaos. Fulton King got a few votes in there as well, as did our return chats with Harmony Sky, Grant McIver, Taylor Bryden. So we've got good few votes in there. Big Demo as well got a nice vote in there also. So yeah, that's it. This year, Alex Webb 2 Into the Webverse was podcast of the year. Like I say, any of these guys that I'm going to see on Saturday, if you're wanting a prize, I will, I don't know, stop at Flying Tiger and get some medals for you. I mean, Aspen's going to end up with, what, 6 at this point. Yeah, it's going to end up with so many. So yeah, that's it. That's the awards this year. I'm going to put them out on the site in about an hour's time at 9 o'clock. So you can all see the nice graphics I've made for this year. It will go on the audio feed as soon as physically possible. And it will go onto YouTube as well as soon as possible. So thank you for continuing to support SWM. Of course, tomorrow's episode is with Grado. We've got Grado coming on to the SWM podcast. I'm so excited that you're able to see it. You're going to see that episode and hear it. Like I say, it was 45 minutes long and it was just an absolute blast. I have some chats lined up soon for future episodes. You can check us on patreon.com/ScottResident and you'll find out first who's coming on to the podcast. And you'll also get to hear the episodes first as well, because you'll get the audio feed, you get the audio version before anyone else gets to see it or listen to it. I can also say that next week's episode will be our road trip. It'll be Station Hotel Showdown. That'll be the episode that's coming out next Friday. Depending on if there's some people I'm speaking to right now to get onto the show. If I get hold of one of them in the interim, then the Station Hotel Showdown episode will probably be a bonus. It'll be like a midweek episode so that I can put out that particular episode that I'm hopefully arranging on Friday, but I don't know. It's a lot of moving parts at the moment, so I don't know what's going to happen and how it's going to work out. But no, that's it. Thank you for continuing to support SWN. I'm so sorry, I have not been able to see comments pop up, so I don't know if you have been commenting. Technology hates me, clearly. That seems to be the way it goes, but hopefully you've enjoyed the show, you've enjoyed the results. If you haven't enjoyed the results, then you know that it was the people, the power of the people that voted for these things. So I've went with people for the results. Thank you for supporting SWN and continue to do so. You can find us on all social media, and hopefully next time you hear me on camera, I sound less congested and COVID-y. So remember, I don't know, take your vitamins, say your prayers, and have a good time. Again, thank you, Lewis. Lewis, it sounds like you've been here the whole time, so I absolutely appreciate that. Thank you. And I hope everyone has a good time. I'm rambling now. So yeah, thank you for supporting SWN.